ओम सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं व्यासाय विष्णुरूपाय व्यासरूपाय विष्णवे नमो वै ब्रह्मनिधये वासिष्ठाय नमो नमः हरिः ओम। सो भगवान कृष्णा वाज एक्सप्लेनिंग अबाउट दिस भिक्षु. So what kind of the tragedies he has gone through, our bhikshu. Very difficult to describe in words. Some words are very difficult. When you take up this Bhagavad study, please go to the Bhikshu Gita. Again and again we have to read to get that kind of mental strength in our life. If you are a leader of the company or a group or some office, so you should not take up this kind of angle. We cannot take it, because be leader, you have to react and you have to become angry to get work done from the people. So role is different. We'll discuss tomorrow the last class. So as an individual, when we are completely away from our life, when we take sannyas, then we have to practice this kind of sadhana. So this should be very, very clear. So many people I have seen this after marrying, getting into family, and they live like sannyasa. Hello, you are grihastha. You have so many responsibilities. So looking at this sadhu sannyas, you are behaving and doing like sannyas. You are in grihastha. Your role is totally different. Many people getting confused with this kind of spirituality. So spirituality is good. When I am there in grihastha, how I have to practice? When I am vanaprastha, I have to practice. So small, small things will get changed according to our position in our life. Again and again, we have to remember one thing. This belongs to the bhikshu sadhu, one who has renounced everything. Therefore, he was not reacting. Is it okay? We try to bring this kind of not reacting to anything in the office, in the home. What will happen? They will reject us. We will not reject the family. Family will reject us. You get out from the family. Go. You are unfit to live in this family. So therefore, we have to remember that point. So this man, the sadhu, has gone through so much of torture, abuse, tragedies. You can tell anything, crisis. All the things he has gone through. After having gone through this kind of experience, he reflected very deeply about the experience and he brought out some message. That message is called Bhikshu Gita. Okay? So today is our, the Bhikshu Gita is going to start. Then 2 days you have told something, that is introduction for Bhikshu Gita. 2 days introduction. No. The subject itself, we have the introduction. So 2 days are picking up the subject. Today and tomorrow he is going to sing the song. Okay, now he is going to sing the song. The Bhikshu Gita. This is a very nice kind of question. What is the cause of our miseries? Or who is the cause of our miseries? Instead of asking what, if I ask who, you will be very happy. Right? What is the cause of our miseries? You just replace what with who. Who is cause of our miseries? I will tell you so many people. I'll start from my own family members. Generally, we see the cause of misery is outside. So when you study Vedanta, when you reflect, then Vedanta is teaching us how to look at this cause inside. Okay. Now, what is the caste of our mission? Generally, we find the caste outside. What are the things we find outside? Whatever we see outside, everything he brought here, sadhu. The first thing, we will blame people. Because of you only, I'm suffering. Like anything. The day I married you, there I lost my freedom. Both the sides I'm telling. Yes, I want to tell the same thing. Before me, you are telling that statement. That's all. Actually, that is my, I thought you are telling. Yeah, I lost my freedom. There's no freedom in this family. How many people? Only two people are living. There's no freedom. I lost my, respect also I lost. And next year, marriage day comes. I'm not going to celebrate, okay? Excuse me. That is the bad day, black day in my life. So we start blaming other people. So what is the cause of your miseries? People. 90% of the world, we look at this cause outside. Point number one. Generally, what we are doing is bringing that point out. People, janaha. Second one, devatas. Devatas are not giving the blessings. Whether subtle devatas living in this body or the devatas who's ruling the universe, devatas are not blessings. Therefore, if I blame people, people will beat me. Therefore, I know that I want to blame them, but they are more powerful than me. Therefore, all my... Because nature is not supporting me, therefore I am suffering in this family. We will shift our attention from people to devata. Devatas. Some people find the reason why I am suffering in this world, in this life. Atma. Because they studied so much Bhagavad Gita, Brahma Sutra. So many texts they studied. Maybe because of my Atma. He brings this. So how can we suffer because of Atma? He brings that kind of argument also. Atma. We see that so many years of people are coming to Vedanta class and study so many texts. After 20, 25 years also, they have so much of confusion. You might have seen people like that. Atma may be the cause of my miseries. Planet, graha. Grahasthiti, Shani. In Tamil, we say Yalra Nattu Shani. 7.5 years. 7.5 years, Shani caught me. I have to go to Thirunallar. So near my Nagapattinam, where I'm staying, Nagapattinam, near my place, Thirunallar. It's international pilgrimage center. All people will come from all over the world on the earth. This is the center point for Shani. Shani dosha. And people are telling you, you don't need to go to a Shani temple. You yourself is Shani. People started blaming Shani, planet. I have to do all parihara dosha. So we are blaming planets. Therefore, we are going to astrologers. Whenever we take our horoscope and you go to astrologers, you have a problem. Exactly, you are telling. Sir, only when we have a problem, then only we'll go to astrology. So simple general truth he will say. We also will say, yes, 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 you are right. You are married. Yes, sir. How do you know? The astrologer also had same kind of problem. Therefore, he can guess. He can say something. So 50% he will say, after that 50%, you also tell your own family problem, personal problem. Then you get into problem. So you try to get out this planet's problem position my life. So because of Graha Dosha, I'm suffering like anything. So he's bringing that point also. The fifth one we are blaming, karma. All my karma. The common people will blame people, other people. Very common. If you learn Vedanta or something, the religious books, then you start blaming my own karma. I'm not blaming you. Because of my karma, I married you. My karma in the shape of this, that's all. Now I understood. start blaming karma. Everything I have done in Pura Janma, therefore I am suffering. You are my father, you are my mother, all because of my karma. And they are all because of my karma only, you came here as my child. So both are blaming karma. Next one, time. My time is not good. Learn narrow. My time is not good. So we start blaming these kind of six aspects in our life. So leaving nothing, he brought all the aspects of life. So one among them we will blame in our life. Or we will blame all the people according to our situation. According to us, my time is not good. All my karma, all because of you only. Our devatas are not blessed. I think my graha dosha. Guru Peirchi. Guru Peirchi. All we have graha dosha. He start blaming this thing. In Bhikshu Gita, he is very a great thinker, the Bhikshu's highest thinker. So in the CBSE syllabus and all, the All India level, the people are doing, the children. When the teachers are teaching, they ask questions and they ask a little powerful question. That question is called a higher order thinking. The question you have to ask in such a way that they should not answer from the paragraph. So they have to read the paragraph and reflect, and they have to bring out their original thought, higher level. These are the original, the normal answers. But the Bhikshu here, he analyzes all the topics he has taken, and he analyzed, he comes into conclusion that these are all not the reason for my misery. For my misery, the absolute reason or the exact reason is mind. Because of my mind, I'm suffering. So this is a little higher thinking. You'll be amazed. And those people who are always asking questions in Vedanta class, for them, this is a very nice topic to think. If you are very the question oriented or thinking oriented, for you, I challenge you, this topic is very good for you. Okay? So it's very difficult to accept. How can you not blaming karma? How you are not blaming time? How you are not blaming planet? All these people are having some part in my sufferings. So everybody is part of my sufferings. Here Bhikshu is telling, I am telling all these people you have to delete. So you are suffering because of your mental condition. So he is bringing a very nice kind of answer. We'll see very interesting answer. Okay. So for many people, this may be a new thought. What? So far I thought this my karma is a reason. My time is reason. Planet is reason. All are having some part in our life. If my mind is okay, then this will not influence me. This is what he says. Okay. Now first he is going to study about the mind. First 5-6 slokas he is spending time on study of the mind. Then he comes to people, devata, kala, atma, planet, karma, and time. So he is going to analyze. Is it okay? So first he told, x is equal to 0. Derive, x is equal to 0. The answer is given. X is equal to 0. You have to prove it. So what's the reason of our problem? Mind. So you have to prove all the things. This is like mathematical analysis. So first he has given, these people are not miseries, the cause of my miseries. Mind is a cause, he told. Now he is going to prove. Now you tell me. Okay, you have given the answer, but you have to prove. Then only my mind will get convinced. So conviction is very important. Otherwise, simply you hear, okay, this man told something, this book is telling something, I hear. But we have to receive and get conviction. Now he is going to take up the mind study. Okay, this is the sloka. Duja Uvacha. This is the 43rd sloka of that particular chapter, 23rd chapter of 11th canto. Now he is starting his song.
Nayam jano me sukha dukha hetor na devatatma graha karma kala manah param karanam amananti samsara chakram parivartayetyat.
So he sings. After having this kind of very powerful treatment from this evil-minded people, he started singing. We also sing, but when we sing, we shed tears. No tears in his eyes, simply ecstasy. It's coming out of ecstasy and joy. Nayam jano me sukha dukkha hetuhu. At least this one sloka you try to memorize. One sloka is more than enough to face many problems in our life. Okay, he says, Nayam jano, I am janaha na. So you have to split na, I am jana. This people is not the cause of my problem. I am janaha na. Me sukha dukkha hetu. Hetu means a reason. These people are not the reason for my sukha dukkha. Then who is there? Devata, na devata, na atma, na graha, na karma, na kala. All the things we have studied now. Okay? These people are not the cause of my problem. I will not blame the devatas. I will not blame my own atma. I will not blame graha, the planet. I will not blame karma and kala, time also. All the aspects we have studied, six aspects. I delete all the six aspects in my life. I will not blame. Very great favor, very great value. The person who is not blaming anyone in this world will be welcomed by everyone wherever he goes. We like that person. Why? No complaint, no blaming. Pleasant kind of person. Greatest value. So I'm not blaming anyone. All the six aspects we studied. Then whom you are going to blame? Manaha. This is my own mind. Mana paramkaranam, paramkaranam amananti. All the scriptures also indicating that. The mind is the root cause of all the problems. Not only this is my decision, all the scriptures also is telling the same thing. I found this truth today. Samsara chakram parivartayet yat samsara chakram. What a great word. Samsara chakram. This only brings happiness and what that? Joy and happiness. Samsara chakram. Up and down. Chakram. Parivartayet. This only brings samsara. The mind alone is a sole cause for turning this wheel of samsara according to the views of great men. Amananti men. Because the scripture says and Veda says. Very beautiful sloka. Whenever we get a problem, you try to reflect on this. Manap param karanam amananti. My mind is creating the problem. No need to blame everything. So when our mind is not good, then we start blaming other people. That's all. If we conquer our mind, all these people will not have an effect on our personality. Powerful sloka. This is called mananam. Mananam means what? Reading the sloka and understanding it. Again and again, if you think over that, then we'll be completely getting clear understanding. When we are getting understanding again and again, then we will not start the people for that. Blaming the people. No complaint. I think when we do so much of reflection, first complaint will move away from us. And blaming people will move away from us. You become a so gentle person in life. Is it okay? The first thing we will not blame. Next thing we will try to find out the root cause. Then we will work on this mind. Now he is identifying mind is a problem, a root cause of all the problems. Is it okay? You may not accept this the first time when you hear. What is this? The new thought. You read again and again, you will be convinced. Okay, the first sloka is a very nice sloka. Mind is a root cause of all the problems. And he's talking about mind. First he has taken the mind for his analysis. Then he moves to delete all other six aspects.
मनो गुणान् वै सृजते बलीयः ततश्च कर्माणि विलक्षणानि शुक्लानि कृष्णान्यतलोहितानि तेभ्यः सवर्णा श्रुतयो भवन्ति.
The meter also very nice to sing. So meter also very big muted to sing. Because when you are in a reflection mood, you need to have big meter. Instead of having smaller one.
Mano gunan vai surjate. Mano only creates, the mind only creates. The powerful mind generates the moods and movements of all the senses. It creates mood. Tatascha karmani vilakshanani. Thereafter we start doing our karma.
Okay, now you are happy. If you, this is really difficult, Sanskrit and English. Now, are you happy? Colorful. Like, you conduct class like this. Colorful. Sharks. Okay. This manaha, this mind, will have three kinds of moods. Gunanvai srijate. Okay, now see this. Now you go. Mano gunanvai srijate baliyaha. This mind creates gunan. So we are very, very popular. What are the gunans? Tamasa, rajasa, sattva. Sattva, rajas, tamas. Mind only creates. Okay, mind creates. Now you understood the first line. Okay. Mano gunanvai srijate baliyaha. Three kinds of the mental vrittis we have. Natascha karmani vilakshanani. Thereafter we start doing karma. So if it is sattva guna, we do japa, study and reflection, thinking, research. Sattva guna. 10 minutes only. Just 10 minutes. Immediately we'll get up and go for a coffee shop. Ask a friend or come. We'll go to canteen, have some coffee. Snacks, rajas. As soon as simply it goes to tamas. That means we'll do tomorrow. What? Study analysis. What is the time now? Morning 10 o'clock. Morning 10 o'clock itself, the mind goes into tamas. So according to our mental vritti, we do activities. Vilakshanani. Whenever sattva comes, activity is different. Rajas and tamas. According to the mental mode, we do activities. Okay, very nicely he is bringing the logic. Okay, when we do activity, Shuklani, Krishnani, Lohitani. See the color. Shukla means white, Krishna means black, Lohita means red. That means so the sattva activity, rajoguna activity, and tamoguna activity. See this, the presentation of the philosophy in poetic form. Sattva, rajas, tamas is a technical word, scientific word. Shuklani, Krishnani, Lohitani is a poetic word. Salt, poetic word. Sodium chloride, technical word. Shuklani, Krishnani, Lohitani. Three kinds of activity. Tebhya Savarna, Shrutayoban. From thereafter only, Shrutayaha. Then we get different type of janmas. Sattva guna, we become man or devata. Rajoguna, ghost. This is ghost only. This is not a thumb has got some, eyes and nose, ghost. This is what available in the internet. Therefore, I brought this kind of ghost. Where is the body? Bodies disappear, only the face is there. We become ghost. Tamas, we become animal. So the jiva is identified with the mind. The mind has got three vrittis. According to the vritti, when he does activity, according to the activity, he takes janma. Therefore, reason for the janma, when we take janma, we suffer. This family, the buffalo janma. Buffalo father, buffalo mother, buffalo children, all. The jiva get into problem. Here only became ghost. I do not know whether ghost has got father ghost, mother ghost. Maybe. There are also some family. And when we become that human being, definitely, we belong to this country, this community, this language, all the things, man, woman, all the things, we get into problem. So our the janma we are taking, we get into problem because of mental vritti. The mental vritti comes because of the mind. Therefore, mind is the root cause of all the problems. This is his analysis. See, how he is analyzing? By taking this mind, you can do one research paper. Take 5-6 slokas, you can write a research paper in the mind. No need to get reference from Vivek Vishuramani, all other things. Only take this Bhikshu Gita, what he says. Write it down. At least 10-15 pages of the information you can get. Okay? This is the... Now you go back and read. Okay? Now see. Mano gunanvai srijate baliya gunan srijati. Tatascha karmani vilakshanani. Thereafter the karma we create. We do. What are the karmas? Shukla, Krishna, Lohita. Black color, white color, red color. That means the mental vritti. Sattva, rajas, tamas. Then tebhyaha savarna. Thereafter only srutayaha van. Then we take janma. That's all. Therefore Krishna says to Arjuna, hey Arjuna, these gunas are the problems. You have to beat this guna by this. immediately we cannot go to sattvaguna. Sattvaguna, suppose we have, now see, very interesting point, we have 90%. No, no, this is too much. Okay. Tamoguna, okay. 60% tamoguna. Okay, then 20% rajoguna we have in our box. So 80. Okay, 10%. Other 20%. 20%. So sadhana means what? We have to reduce this. So we have to reduce 50%, and this may be 30%, and this may be 20%. You have to increase this. And slowly, slowly, we have to go from what, that tamas to rajas, rajas to sattva. Then after that, we have to go beyond the mind. Going beyond the mind is called nisray gunyaha. So this is what explains our Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. Oh, one complete chapter he dedicates. How to handle this three? This is mechanism of mind. The mechanism of mind is explained in Bhagavad Gita, how to get out. Very brilliant chapter. See, study about Paramatma, Atma is okay. That is a goal. So on the way, how I have to handle the problems? If the mechanic, if you know the mechanism of the car, how to handle whatever the problem I get on the road, if I know how to handle it, the destination is definite for me. So I know very well about destination, but I do not know how to handle the problem of the car on the way. I hope you are getting it. Yeah. So the mechanism of our system is very, very important for our successful travel, successful journey. Where this is what we have to study. Therefore, in Bhagavad Gita, he is explaining more about the goal. Yad gatvana nivartande taddhama paramamam. Okay, goal is okay. Little study is enough about goal. But on the path, whatever the problem I get, I have to overcome those problems. This mechanism you have to study. When tamas comes, how to get out. Rajas comes, how to get out. So our Swami Vivekananda came here to wake us from tamas. This is the quality. From this only he started. We get up, arise, awake from the mental sleep. You come here. From here you can go to here very easily. Okay. This is the mind. So mind has got the three vrittis because of that only. So he analyzed one aspect. No, other aspect of the mind. Okay. We'll go to next sloka. This is very nice sloka. Very brilliant sloka. If you like someone, some sloka, please try to memorize it, try to keep it. Write down. You know, what that cell phone you can have. While you are driving, you can chant. Not looking at this cell phone, excuse me. When you memorize, Nayam jano me sukha dukkha hetu, like that you can sing and drive the car. Very nice sloka. This is very powerful sloka. Nanam sodharmo niyamo yamascha srutam cha karmani cha sadvratani sarve mano nigraha lakshanantaha parohi yogo manasa samadhihi. Very nice sloka. What he says, you just leave this. I will send this translation. Just leave. You see this original. Very nice. The original word is tasty. Okay? Original word is taste. The first you cook fresh food, you eat it. And you keep it in the fridge and you take it. Something is last. The fresh food from the kitchen. The fresh one. Danam. Dana means dan. The charity. We do charity. We have so much of money to charity. People are appreciating us. What a generous mind he has got. Charity. Danam. You do dan. Swadharmaha. Go to office and do our dharma. As an officer, I have to take this action. I do not see any partiality. Swadharma, great man. Like Arjuna, he started doing his work throughout the life. Perfect man. Niyamaha, all the niyamas and yamas. I will show you what is yama and niyama. The five values of yama, five values of niyama, this is described in Yoga Shastra, Ashtanga Yoga. Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. All the eight angas of the yoga. So Yama, Niyama, we will see that. So Tamsa Karmani, whatever we hear, the scripture study, Karmani, Satvartani. Whatever we study, Sri Tamsa Karmani. And whatever the karmas, what do you call, social activities, without expecting anything. social activities, Satvratani. We observe so many vratas. Every Saturday, vrata for Lord Venkateshwara. Every Ekadasi, vrata for Lord Vishnu. Every Friday, vrata for Parvati Devi. So all the vratas we do. Or Sabarimala vrata. Palani Murugan, all this vrata. Shrutam, whatever you study, whatever karma. Sarve mano nigraha lakshananda. If you are interested, you memorize the whole sloka. Otherwise, you just remember this line itself. More than enough. Sarve mano nigraha lakshanantaha. Very powerful line. Sarve. Whatever the sadhanas we are doing, all these kinds of sadhanas. It is not important. It is not very, what that? We are the compulsory, you have to do japa or this kind of thing. If you are good in scripture study, study and reflect. That is your sadhana. If you are good in the dharma dana, that is your sadhana. You take something is your main sadhana, other aspects are secondary one. What do we think this person is always doing japa? I'm not able to do japa. I do not know what to do. We compare ourselves with other person and we feel depressed. Sir, our personality is totally different. Every personality is different, different personality. According to our taste, we can take some sadhanas, main sadhana. So, dhanam, swadharma, niyamo, yamascha, srutam, chakarmani, sattvartani, sarve, mano, nigraha, lakshananta. All these have control of the mind. Control of the mind as their one subject. The main aspect of all the sadhanas to bring mind under our control. That's all. Whatever we may do. All the sadhanas meant to control the mind. That's all. This is the powerful line. We go to pilgrimage. That's also to bring one mind under our control. Sarve mano nigraha lakshananta. Mano nigraha. Parohi yoga manasa samadhi. This line is very good. Parohi yoga. This is the greatest yoga. Greatest yoga. Yoga manasa samadhi. To bring the mind under our control, if mind becomes quieted, that is the greatest yoga. See the appreciation of mind control here. Mind should be under our control. We have to purify the mind. Sarve mano nigraha lakshananta parohi yoga manasa samadhi. When we bring the mind under control, that is the greatest yoga. Why he started telling we have to blame the mind. We have to criticize the mind. We should not criticize other people outside. So the problem is inside of the personality, not outside of the personality. Therefore, this is analyzing. All the activities we are doing or we are doing all sadhanas to bring mind under control. That's all. When we have done this, then we reached yoga. Okay? Very nice. And the yama niyama. I'll give you the list, the Yama Niyama. Okay? This is Yama and this is Niyama. For the 10 qualities. So whatever you practice, Ahimsa we practice. Ahimsa, Satya, Asteya, Brahmacharya, Aparigraha. This is Yama. Okay? Non-harming or non-violence. We cannot ask the people, you don't harm anyone. We don't harm anyone. Sir, that is general rule. So we apply general rule in our life. If you become Kshatriya, your job to harm the enemies. There the concept of Ahimsa is a little different. Okay? So how to understand Ahimsa, how to apply Ahimsa. Satyam, truthfulness. Asteyam, non-stealing. Brahmacharya, celibacy. Aparigraham, non-hoarding. Or non, what that? Aggrandizing. Not aggrandizing the things. Na aparigraha. These are the Yama. And this is Niyama. Saucham, Santosham, Tapas, Swadhyayam, Ishwara, Pranidana. Saucham, the cleanliness, Santosham, contentment. Santosham, for the spiritual student, the good quality is always you have to be very happy. Oh, I do not have anything to become happy. Because you renounce everything, you are the happiest person. If you hold something, then you have to protect it. Then the worry comes. Renounce everything, then you are the happiest person. Santosham should be there. Tapas, austerity should be there. Swadhyaya, he has to study the scripture and reflect. And Ishwara Pranidhanam, surrender. If you notice, these niyamas may be the personal values, this yama may be the social values. if you notice. You getting it? Sauchayas belongs to us. So first, I have to be clean. Santosham. Santosham means this is my mental quality. And tapas also, I am doing Varadam. Swadhyaya, I study. Okay. All this belong to the Jiva. Ishvara Parinara. So I go and do Namaskar. Here, Ahimsa, I am not disturbing others. Okay. This is a social connection. All these values are having social connection when you live in the society. These are our personal values. When you go to your home, you practice this. When you come out of the home, you practice this. That's all. So, Yama and Niyama, all these 10 qualities, Satvartani, Karmani, whatever we do in our life, okay? Now you go back. So, Dhanam, Swadharma, Yama, Niyama, Shrutam, Karmani, Satvartani, whatever. Sarve, Mano, Nigaraga, Lakshananta. Powerful shloka. Don't forget this line. Sarve maro nigraha lakshananta. That's the purpose of all the sadhanas, whatever it may be. And we should not, many, if you take the 63 Nayanmars, the great devotees of Lord Shiva, those who lived in Tamil Nadu, so many hundreds of years back, 63 devotees, Nayanmargal. So one Nayanmar sitting always what that. Standing in the river and started chanting Purusha Suktam as much as possible. Only by chanting Purusha Suktam, he attained Lord Shiva. See there. He has taken up that sadhana, has his own sadhana. The sadhana, whichever sadhana our mind is tasting it, our mind is liking it, we can keep that sadhana as a main one. So what happens in our life? We compare with other people. So he is not eating so much. I am eating so much. I do not know how to do my sadhana. Sorry. His personality, he is able to absorb this kind of vratam. So we should not compare with other people. Otherwise, we get into problems. So our mind says, I am not doing anything. I am not doing anything. I am not progressing, sir. Every individual is made in a different mental structure. Okay. So that kind of feeling, no need to have in our life. Whichever is good for us, that you can take and we can follow. Okay? Moving forward. Yama and Yama we have studied. Sarve mano nigraha lakshananta. You have to remember this line. Very nice line. Going to next look. Study on what the mind. Mind analysis only he is doing.
Samahitam yasya mana prashantam dhana dibih kim vadatasya krityam asamyatam yasya maro vinashyat dhana dibhirshchet aparam kimebi.
Very nice question is asking. If a man's mind has already attained a single mindedness, samahitam yasya manam samahitam yasya manaha samahitam, the person who controlled the mind and he brought the mind under his control, prashantam, already has done, achieved. Dana adibihi kimvada. What is the purpose of doing dhanam? I hope you're getting it. The person who brought the mind under his control, then what is the purpose of doing dhanam? Just leave it. Why you achieved? You achieved to bring the mind under complete control. No need of dhanam. What is the use of dhanam? This question, okay? The same question in the other way. Asamyatam yasya manaha. Yasya manaha asamyatam. Here, yasya manaha samahitam. Okay, yasya manaha samahitam. One who controlled. Here, yasya manaha asamyatam. The person who is not controlled his mind. Okay, dana adibihi kimebi. Because he is not working on his mind, then what is the purpose of doing dana? There is no purpose. He is doing only dana, but he is not working on his mind. I hope we're getting it. The purpose of doing dhanam to bring the mind under our control. So we see many people and we are getting confused. This person is doing dhanam and he's doing all the things he's doing, but he's doing still problem in his life. What is this? We are getting confused. So here the sloka says, you do dhanam, swadharmam, vratam, everything. At the same time, you have to work on your mind to bring the mind under your control. The sadhana should have some impact on our mind control. Otherwise, there is no purpose of doing sadhana. So why we are not improving in our life? Simply we are doing physical activity as a sadhana and we are not working. What is that? The main work we are not doing on the mind. Therefore the sloka says, asamyatam yasyama, you are not working on the mind. But what is the purpose of doing dana? Waste. For namesake only we are doing that. When you do dana, that should have some impact on your mind. Otherwise there is no need. When you clean our house by broomstick or some vacuum cleaner, there should be some cleanliness. Nothing is clean. Then why you are wasting your time? This is what the question he asks. How you are getting, okay? Once the mind is under control, then what is the purpose of dana? There is no purpose. If mind is not controlled, then what is the purpose of giving the dana? That means whatever the sadhana we are doing, that sadhana should have impact on our mind. That's all. So, getting it? We have a pipeline and we have tap also. We have water tank. Water tank is full of water. In the tap also the water comes. You open the water, instead of water, air comes. Bus. You go and check, water tank is filled with water. There's no problem. Pump also is working perfectly. Water tank water is there, but water is not coming there. Line loss. So all the waters are going outside the same ways. When you do dana, the dana should have impact on the mind. Otherwise, what is the purpose of doing that? So much of dollars, thousands of dollars we have done dana, but no mind control. Then he's asking, what is the purpose of giving the dana? I hope you understood the point, what he is going to convey. He wants to convey. Okay? So every sadhana should have some impact on the mind. That is the point. This is the next sloka. It's very nice sloka. Bhishma is coming here. Name Bhishma. Why is called Bhishma? So you can find the reason why Bhishma is called Bhishma here. Okay? Mano vashenye hyabhavan smadeva manaschana nyastavasham naya sameti bhishmo hideva sahasa sahiyana yunjadvashetam sahideva devaha. Very nice. Mano vashe anye devaha mano vashe abhavan sma. Anye devaha, all the devatas are under the control of mind. All the devatas also under the control of mind. What devatas? Whatever the devatas we have in the body. Indra, Varuna, Agni, all the devatas, every limb has got the devata. All these devatas also, they do not know how to bring the mind under their control. Mind is taking all the devatas. So, Anye Deva, and also very interesting this. Anye Deva, Manovashe Bhavanasma. All devatas are under the influence of mind. So mind is so powerful. Okay. Manascha na anyasya vasham na yeti. Mind is not going behind the devatas. Even though the Adhishtana devatas also, they do not know how to bring mind under their control. Mind is going very faster. So mind is not listening to devata. All the devatas are behind the mind. Is it okay? See how he is analyzed. Bhishmohi deva sahasa sahiyan. The mind is the most powerful thing in the world. Okay? This formidable entity, mind, is most powerful than any other center of power. Mind is a powerful center of Bhishmohi deva. Bhishma means bhayangarata. Deva. What is this? The mind is the devata. It's very powerful thing. Which is very difficult to control. Yunjadvashe, the person who controls this mind, tam, you call that person as Deva Devaha. He's a master of all senses, he's Deva Deva. He is more than Devata. The person who controls the mind is more than Devata. Highest task of life. Yes, I too agree. Every time I make attempt, failure. I do not know what to do. Keep trying, that's all. keep on trying. In one janma we will attain. No need to worry. Anek janma samsiddha. Atoyati param gatim Krishna. Sanoga anek janma samsiddha. We keep on trying, trying, trying. One day we will win over. Lord's grace is there. So while we are living our life in the or that vyavahara life, at the same time, we have to give little time to work on the mind also. Okay? Because immediately we cannot shift. Immediately if we shift, then our mind will get upset. So while we are living, small time. No, slowly, slowly we have to increase the time in the spiritual path. Slowly, slowly we have to shift. Bhishmo hi deva sahasa. He says mind is Bhishma. Bhishma means bhayangarata. Terrible. The Bhishma word here he uses to refer the mind as a terrible mind. Arjuna also says in Bhagavad Gita 6th chapter, this is very terrible. The person who controls Deva Deva, more than Deva, this is a certificate he gives. Why? We know what is mind, how to control. Simple thing, when we become angry, how much time it takes to bring it back from the anger? Just to analyze our, if we get the impact of this anger, the whole body, the mind, the work also, it reflects anger. Jealousy. We know that we should not get jealousy, but mind takes us. We don't know how to come out from the jealousy. The person is very conscious. I am jealous of this person. But it's how to get out. Tough project. If I get desire, how to bring my mind back from the desire? Oh, tough job. Ego. My ego is hurt. How to bring back? So the people, those who are conscious of mind also, they are working very hard to come out of mind. Depression. The small bad words, the bad words they used in the public. So I was insulted. How to come out my insult? Very, very powerful thing. Very subtle mind and subtle negative value. How to bring this mind from subtle negative values? Toughest project. This is called spiritual sadhana. How to come out? There. You go to Bhagavad, same Bhagavad. We study that crocodile caught the elephant's leg. There. Gajendra Moksham. There if you go, Gajendra is so powerful. And he goes in this pond, the crocodile caught Gajendra's leg. The crocodile has got so much power in the water. The Gajendra is more powerful than the crocodile. When the crocodile comes to the land, the Gajendra will smash it. But in the pond, crocodile has got more power than Gajendra. Gajendra is none other than Jiva. The crocodile is none other than the mind. So mind, the samsara, is so powerful. The fight between Jiva and the mind. So you want to get out of the mind, the subtle crocodile, it's getting over, not leaving. By God's grace and by great sadhana, we can come out. It's the toughest project. If you go and read that part of Gajendra Moksha, and Bhagavan Vedavyasa says that so many thousands of years they were fighting. And children will ask, how this is possible? Many thousands of years they were fighting. This is the story kept there. Thousands of years they were fighting means what? In many, many janmas, Jiva is fighting with mind to get from this clutches of the mind. So this is the story. This is the philosophy behind that story of Gajendra Moksha. Somehow I want to get out from the mind. All kinds of negative values. Shat vairi. Kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, mastery. All the vairis. The toughest project. We have to do it. Bhishma. You see, why Bhishma is called? So with this, so I want to bring why Bhishma is called Bhishma. Okay. So I brought that slokas from Mahabharata. Just we'll touch and we'll move forward. Why Bhishma? Simply he is calling mind as Bhishma. Now in Mahabharata Adipara, if you go, Bhishma was asked by that the fisherman. So Shantanu wants to marry the fisherman's daughter, Satyavati. Bhishma goes and he says that, please, you give your daughter to my father. Let him marry. So Satyavati's father was asking that. So whatever the child she gets, that child should become the king. Already you are son of your father, Shantanu. So otherwise, my children, my child and my grandchild will not get any power. This man says this kind of thing. Bhishma told, yes, okay. Today onwards, I will not marry, I will not get children. So he takes this powerful vow there. Okay. Adya prabhrdime dasha brahmacharyam bhavishyati. He says that today onwards, I will practice brahmacharya. Complete 100% brahmacharya I will practice. I will not take position, power, no marriage, no children. He says that. This is from Mahabharata. Okay. Tato antariksha apsarasa deva sarishigana. All the rishis, antariksha, deva, gandharva, all these people started coming and pouring. Flower, what do you call, pushpa vrishti. And they say, abhya varchanta kusumaihi. They have, what that? Then this pushpa vrishti. All the devatas and they told him, Bhishmoyam, this man is terrible man. Bhishmoyam. So his name was Devavrata. Bhishma's name was Devavrata. When he has taken this brahmachari vrata, his name has become Bhishma. Living with so much of comforts. Everything is available in that palace. Leaving everything, I'm going to observe the brahmachari vrata. Brahmachari vrata means what? Giving up everything, that's all, leaving the palace. Because his karma is like that one. When he took this kind of vrata, Bhishmoyam, terrible person. Very difficult. So Bhishmoyam, Sametascha Pratakchave, Bhishmoyam iti Chaburvan. Devatas only kept the name Bhishma. Okay? His father is very happy. You have taken or you have given complete life because of my simple desire. Oh, dear son, you get the Swachanda Maranam Dasmai Dadau. Whenever you want to die, you can die. The Swachanda Maranam is the boon given by Shantanu Maharaj. Why he is called Bhishma? You're powerful. He controlled everything there itself. Finished. He brought the mind under his control and he has taken very powerful vow. Therefore, his name is Bhishma. The same word Bhishma is used here by our Bhikshu. Okay? That's the very toughest project. We cannot say this is not possible. This is possible. It will take time. That's all. In this Janma or many Janma. So we have to take up the project. Sign the application. Fill up your name. Sign the application. Give it to Lord. Keep it at the feet of the Lord. Lord says, are you going to control your mind? Yes, Lord. Sir, I want to do a PhD.
You?
I don't see any ability in you to do a PhD. That in philosophy. Anyway, Lord is very compassionate. Lord, he takes application. Okay, you are allowed. What is that? Admission is given. Lord says, admission given. I am poorest student. Very weakest student, but Lord is very compassionate. Admission is given. Come on. Your interest is very important than your qualification. Anyway, you come. Application is granted. Yeah, allowed. You go into the university. We go. How many years back you went to university? 10 years back. What is your thesis? First you submit your, what do you call, small, what do you call, you submit, I forgot that, what do you, 5-6 lines, what is that? Synopsis, yeah, synopsis you have to submit. 10 years back I joined, no synopsis, no ideas coming. Anyway, Lord is very compassionate, anyway, you continue. After 50 years also you can submit, come on. This is a compassionate God. So we have to take up the project. Mind control. Lord is very. Lord will laugh at us. You, mind control. Anyway, come on, anyway. Allowed. So in Lord's university, everybody is allowed. Very compassionate. He will give us very nice opportunity, nice ability to control. Anyway, we have to take up the project. Okay? And he says, Tam sudurjayam, durjayam, shatrum asahya vegam, Amarantudam Tanna Vijitya Kechit Kurvanti Asad Vigraham Atra Martyehi Mitra Ari Udasira Ripun Vimuda. Very nicely says. Tam Durjayam, it's very difficult to control the mind. Shatru. So we have Shatru in our own personality. The mind itself is Shatru. When those who studied 6th chapter Bhagavad Gita. Okay. Atmaiva Atmano Banduhu Atmaiva Ripuratmanaha. So we are our own enemy, we are our own
friend. He says that our own shatru is there inside your mind. So without that controlling, without overcoming your enemy inside, you are coming outside and kurvanti asad vigraham. They do asad vigraham atra martyahi with the people. What kind of fighting we are starting outside? Mitra, Ari, Udasi, Naripun. So he is my friend, he is my enemy. So we do all kinds of vigraham outside. And we fight with the people outside instead of fighting with the mind inside. So our own enemy is our own mind. Instead of fighting inside, we are coming and fighting outside. This is what I understood. Our Bhikshu says, very brilliant thing. Very brilliant. Okay, now see. We come outside and quarrel outside. Whether it's verbal or physical, would hurt. Whatever we see outside, people are fighting out, quarreling. Actually, we have to conquer the mind inside. Krishna says, Arjuna, hey Arjuna, Viddhi, enamiha vairinam. You understand your own enemy is your desire and your krodha. Kamayesha krodhayesha rajoguna samudbhavaha mahashano mahapapma vidyenamiha vairinam. Your internal enemy is your desire and anger. First you fight with this. Your Mahabahu. Yes, hey, the person has got the shoulder. So you, instead of fighting outside, first fight inside. First conquer outside, all the quarrel will stop, will be stopped outside. Because we are not able to conquer inside, therefore we are finding outside the problem. This is my enemy, this is me. What a great lessons. Powerful lessons for Vedanta. Therefore, Gurudev brought this kind of Vedanta. First, you change yourself to change the world. What he says? World perfection through the individual perfection. This is sloka brought out by our Gurudev from Himalayas. What a great truth, eh? Powerful truth. Only Vedanta can bring the inner peace and external, internal peace and external harmony. A person who studied Vedanta and practiced the Vedanta, he can lead very nice family life and he can bring happiness to the society. Why? He understands the truth of the life, secret of the life. What a powerful secret. Huh? Which religion will teach this kind of thing? Buddhism also almost closer to our Hinduism. Buddhism also will have this kind of thoughts. Great thinkers are there in Buddhism, Buddha philosophy. But the root is from Sanatana Dharma. No, what kind of lesson? Start looking at it. Because of my problem, I brought this kind of bad words. So I created a problem outside. If I know how to control inside, the bad words will not come. People will not become enemies. Simple. So what we say outside is a reflection of our inside. Brilliant thought. Brilliant life transformation we can bring. Okay. First we have to convince ourselves. Then only it is possible. For how he is able to control this kind of bad experience, because he understood, I am not controlling inside, therefore I am getting outside. What he says, all the people abused me and they treated me. All kinds of the nasty things they have done for me. I am not blaming these people. All this is because of my mind. Manakara paramkaraman karanam amanan. Because of mind, I understood them like this. So I understood everything is happening in my mind. Therefore, this is the physical hurt only. That's all. There's no problem. He understood about his mind. Therefore, he has taken the incident very easily. The knowledge only releases from all kinds of problems. What kind of knowledge? This kind of knowledge. As we get more and more, see, knowledge means not studying so many texts. I hope you are getting. Knowledge means not studying so many Brahma Sutra, this and that, Bhagavad Gita, all commentary. I studied all the bestseller books. Sir, that is study, information. The knowledge means what we understood, what we practice, how we digested, how we practice. This is called knowledge. Okay? So knowledge means it should have some great impact on our practical life. Then this is knowledge. I studied so many things. That is information.
Anybody who has got interest in study, they can get information. Information is different, but the knowledge about life, practice is so important. Okay? అని దేహం మనో మాత్రమివం గృహీత్వా మమాహమితి అందదియో మనుష్యాః ఏషో అహం అన్యః అయమితి భ్రమేణ దురంతపారే తమసి భ్రమంతి. నౌ సీ దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఐ హావ్ బ్రాట్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ పిక్చర్. ఓకే, సో మైండ్ థింగ్స్ ద మైండ్ ఓన్లీ థింగ్స్ ఐ ఆమ్ ద బాడీ. ఓకే, మైండ్ ఐ ఆమ్ ద బాడీ, మైండ్ కమ్స్ డౌన్ ఐ ఆమ్ దిస్ బాడీ. When I identify myself, this body, I say, I. Non, I. When I say, I, this is you and this is you. One section. I don't like. I like you. This is you and this is me. Whenever I get me and you, in the you, you had two divisions. I like you, I don't like you. When the divisions we make, I don't like, I like, then the problems started. I support this group, I don't support this group. So the group I support, they will come with me. The group I don't support, they will send all kinds of emails and messages. They will go to police court and get into problem. Then we get to problem. As soon as we identify, the mind identifies the body thinks I am I. When I get I, you comes. When you comes, I don't like you, I like you. Then the problem comes, we get into problem. So all the reasons for our problem is mind, he says. See the analysis. So mind is a problem. So I have to work on this mind, I have to get out of the mind. This is what he says in this sloka. Very simple. Okay? Then he starts. Now so far he has understood everything, he has studied on mind. దేహం మనో మాత్రం ఇవం. దేహం ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ద మైండ్. ఓకే, గృహీత్వ హ్యావింగ్ హోల్డింగ్ మమ దిస్ మైండ్, మమ అహం, ఐఎమ్ దిస్ బాడీ, ఆల్ మై యాక్టివిటీ, మమ అహం ఇది. అంధదియ మనుష్య, మనుష్య అంధదియ మీన్స్ ఈస్ బ్లైండెడ్, బ్లైండెడ్ దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ థాట్. ఐఎమ్ దిస్ బాడీ, ఆల్ దిస్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ అవే ఫ్రమ్ మీ. ఏషో అహం అన్యో అయం, దిస్ ఇస్ మీ, దిస్ ఇస్ అదర్ పర్సన్. భ్రమేణ, బై దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ కన్ఫ్యూషన్. దురంతపారే తమసి భ్రమంతి, ది ఎండ్లెస్ డార్క్నెస్ హీ ఈస్ లివింగ్ దిస్ వరల్డ్. సి హౌ హిస్ వెరీ థాట్ ప్యాటర్న్ ఇస్ వెరీ నైస్లీ ఇస్ బ్రింగింగ్ ద మైండ్ ఐడెంటిఫైస్ విత్ ద బాడీ. ఐ థాట్ కమ్స్, మై థాట్ కమ్స్, ఐ డోంట్ లైక్, ఐ లైక్ ఇట్, దెన్ ఐ గెట్ ఇన్ టు ప్రాబ్లమ్. సో వెరీ నైస్లీ హీ ఈస్ బ్రింగింగ్ ద థాట్ ఫ్లో. ఓకే, నౌ వీ హ్యావ్ స్టడీడ్ అబౌట్ ద మైండ్ సో ఫార్. నౌ హీ ఈస్ బ్రింగింగ్ ద ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్ నెంబర్ one, first argument. Like this sixth argument he brings that, now I explained, mind is the reason for all the problems, I explained. Now he is telling, I am going to explain, or I am going to delete all the six aspects of life. Why I am not blaming the people? Why I am not blaming the devata? Why I am not blaming graha, karma, kala? Okay? So I am going to give you the reason. Logical reasoning he is giving. Why I am not blaming. So this argument, six arguments, very nice kind of thinking he brings. So this we will see tomorrow. Ayyo. Today he explained about mind. Only mind. Study on mind. Or analysis on mind. You never get this kind of message anywhere in the world. Generally, people will talk mind, mind, mind. So what is mind? How you have to understand what it works, the function of mind. How it is the root cause of all the problems is discussed. Okay? And how to bring the control of mind, then you go to sixth chapter. Something you can take from sixth chapter. Whatever you are missing here, you can go and take from sixth chapter. How to control, how to bring mind under control. Shanaihi, shanaihi, uparamed, Krishna says. Slowly, slowly how to work. It's not one day project or one week project. Lifetime project. Slowly, slowly, slowly. Evolution. The evolution comes slowly only. But we start our journey. We have to start our journey. Lord is very compassionate. He will help. I tell you, Lord is so compassionate. And you do so many mistakes, he will forget and I will give you one more chance to come out. Brilliant. His grace is very brilliant. And I will give you one more chance. You keep on trying. One day you will win. You come and reach me. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa says that if a sadhaka takes one step towards God, okay, God will take 10 steps towards us. Okay, na? What? So he's waiting for us. You take one step, da, I will take 10 steps. Okay, start. Tomorrow, Ekadesi, I will start God. Hey, start today. Yeah, January 1st, I will start. Hey, show. Start today. So when we take step, he's very compassionate. Lord is so great. Great person, Lord. Okay, he's waiting for us. Now he will start argument. We will see tomorrow these arguments. Brilliant arguments. Sometimes it's very difficult to understand. I tell you, if you follow, it's very easy only. The translation and all, I have seen the translations sometimes very difficult to understand the translation also. But I will explain, you can understand very easily. I brought the pictures also, okay? The pictures also. Every argument I have picture, don't worry. So it's very easy to understand, okay? All the pictures. Whether you understand the logic or not, you see the pictures, you will be happy, okay? Okay? Don't worry. So tomorrow I will see this argument and we'll conclude tomorrow. Well, tomorrow is the main thing. Today he has explained about the root cause of the problems as mind. Tomorrow is going to eradicate all other problems. It's very nice logic. So yesterday I was explaining you about this temple project. So this is the information for your donation for the temple. Okay. So if you want, you can take this screenshot. Then I have sent this information to Dinesh also. Yes. Samath also, you can get from them also. Okay, right. Now I got a question. One question we got. Very nice question today. Shall we move for this question? How do I know what is my dharma to follow? This is from Pani. Mr. Pani, le? Yeah, okay. It is based on my birth varna. Is it based on my birth varna? So birth. How do I know what is my dharma? How? I know my dharma. Is it based on my birth? Or is it different from my birth varna? My birth varna. Birth varna. How do I realize what is my dharma path? The same question only. Krishna instructed Arjuna to follow his dharma by fighting. For example, yes. Krishna instructed Arjuna. Okay. The point is it based on my birth or is it based on my nature? That is the question, your question. Okay. The two things in your life. Oh. That's it. This is birth, okay? Birth, and this is nature. So in the vyavahara world, okay, vyavahara, this is paramarthika means spiritual world. So if you are a spiritual person, religious person, or you follow dharma, so you take this aspect of your dharma. Go with your nature, the mental vritti. According to Bhagavad Gita, Chaturvarnya Maya Srishtam Guna Karma Vibhagashaha. You just follow this. Paramarthika. As a spiritual student, so my path is this. So I go by nature. When you come into Vyavahara world, the worldly people, then you are living in the society, then you go by birth, your birth, that's all. Because your certificate also has got the community. In India and all, we have birth certificate and the community also is there. If I speak Tamil, then I have to go with Tamil people. If I speak Kannada, then go with Kannada people. Then Malayalam, go with Kerala. That's all. So I was there in one center of our US center, and they were celebrating Onam celebration. All the people, those who belong to Kerala, they speak Malayalam, they come and celebrate, community oriented. By birth, I belong to this. There's no wrong in it. You have to participate. So we have Vyavahara Dharma, you have this Paramatika Dharma. So the Vyavahara, so you have to consider yourself by birth, then you participate in this program, Darsa. But you are very, very conscious that actually speaking, the real thing is belongs to my Macher and Paramarthika. You're getting it? Now there will not be any confusion. Suppose we are very rigid in this. I am according to my nature, my spiritual path, I am like this. Veera Shaiva, Veera Vaishnava. This. You are not flexible enough to understand what, how we have to live in the practical life. Then we create a problem with ourselves at the same time, the society also. I hope you are understanding this standpoint. Okay? Yeah. By birth, I am Brahmana. Okay? By birth, I am Brahmana. I have all the signs of Brahmana. The family tradition I follow. Everything is okay. But by nature, I am trader, the business person. Then you have to do all your business. Whenever the community is asking you to come and participate, you have to pursue. You should not tell me, hey, by nature, I am businessman. I will not come and participate. We are creating problem. When the community calls, then we have to go and appear and we have to work for that community. Because social setup is totally different from this. If you are elevated from this kind of social setup, then we become spiritual student. If somebody is asking you, who are you? We should not say, Aham Brahmasmi. Sir, you are in Vyavahara world. They are asking your identity. They are not asking your nature. Suppose you find guru like elevated guru, there you should not say, I am Brahmana. There you have to say, Naham Brahmana, Naham Kshatriya, Aham Brahmasmi. That's it. So when you understand this position in your life, where we are living, with whom we are living, what kind of society we belongs to, which kind of plane, according to we have to take it. But our soul understanding should be based on our nature, Paramarthika, and we have to go with Bhagavad Gita and Upanishad only. I hope you understand, okay? So our dharma, so then what is your final thing? Okay, how I have to live practically. This is how we have to live practically. But when we ask this question, this you have to go with your nature. By your nature, you have to go with Krishna only. Krishna and Arjuna only. Okay? So even though I am by birth a Brahmana, my nature is business nature. My nature is Kshatriya. So I have to go with Kshatriya for my evolution. I understood what is scripture says. Then I have to go Kshatriya kind of work and business kind of work. By birth, I am Brahman. Okay, by birth, I am Brahman. By my vritti is not like Brahmana vritti. But I have taken birth in that family. By my vritti is totally different. Therefore, I have to follow my vritti to get evolution. When community calls me, then I have to go and appear there also. Okay, this is worldly activities. I have to participate. But really, my nature is Kshatriya vritti. I have to do it. I hope you understand this. So you are, Swadharma, you have to do according to the scripture, according to Bhagavad Gita. I hope understood. Now, one more. So last I was doing a Mahabharata class for Ann Arbor. So there I brought one chart. So that chart yesterday I lost this chart. I do not know whom I told this. Because so many centers, so far this is the 8th center I am doing Yajna. This chart where I discussed, I lost. So after 1 hour, I was working and brought this chart. Okay, this was discussed with the people Ann Arbor. There I took the same chart I brought here. This is x-axis, the mathematics. Okay, y-axis. Am I right? Mathematicians, this is x, and this is y in the mathematics. So in the x-axis you bring Varna Dharma, in y-axis you bring Ashrama Dharma. Okay, Varna Dharma is horizontal, and all the people are talking in Tamil Nadu. Those who want to make politics, they are telling Varna Dharma is vertical. No, Varna Dharma is horizontal.
If you go and search in the Google image and all, if you go, just take Varna, Varna will come like this. You see the picture like this. Okay, Varna, Varna Dharma. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. This is wrong kind of picture. This is not explained in our scriptures like this. Varna is horizontal. Ashrama is vertical. Now, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. Is it okay? This is the, all are horizontal. We have our position in our life. Nobody is higher and nobody is lower. According to scripture, all are equal. Swakarmana tamabhyarcha siddhim vindati manava. According to your nature, you work, you contribute your work to the society and you grow. This is what Bhagavad Gita says. Krishna also very clear. There is no problem in Bhagavad Gita. There is no problem in Manudharma. There is a problem of the people, those who are following that dharma. They get ups and down and they create problem in the society. So these people are thinking that I am lower. These people are thinking I am higher. So this is the problem of the mental vritti of the mind problem of the mental problem of the people. They create ups and downs the society. There is no problem with the scriptures. Scriptures are very clear. Okay. So scriptures are telling the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. According to mental guna karma vibhagasha, the classification of human beings are happened according to our vritti, guna and action. If a thinker and administrator, trader and skilled worker, instead of Sanskrit, you translate into English, there's no problem. If you say Brahmana, Shudra, people are very allergic with this word. You translate it, thinkers, administrators, businessmen and skilled worker. Shudra means you should not, I'm Shudra, I'm very lower. Sir, Shudra means skilled worker. It is very, very rare to find skilled worker nowadays. They work only 50% and they work, so that kind of people you find. So work 100% skilled. Other person cannot come and touch on this work. The improvement should not be made on that work. That is called skilled work. Okay, these people contribute to the society. These people, they bring money, they bring work. These people are giving the direction, controlling everything, and these people are giving the direction. The whole society is directed by Brahmana, thinker. The whole society is controlled by Kshatriyas, administrator. The prosperity brought out by Vaishya, and work is done by skilled work. All the whole society should go together. The whole system of human body is made in such a way that thinking aspect, sure, protecting aspect, administration, the thighs are the Vaishya aspect, you have to hold. The whole system is standing on the feet. Brahmanoho Samukamasid Bahu Rajanya Kritaha Uru Tatasya Dvaishya Padhyagam Shudro Ajayata. Shudro Ajay. This is what Purusha Sustam says. Very scientific classification, horizontal. There is no ups and downs in this. Varana Dharma. Varana means a description, not the color here. Description of the mental vritti. Okay? Horizontal. So this vertical aspect is Brahmacharya, Grahastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyas. Vertical. So individual life, this ashrama belongs to individual person. Varana belongs to social setup. The social setup, there is no ups and downs. In the individual, there is for the hierarchy. So before marriage, I am Brahmacharya. After marriage, so I have to grow vertically. I have to become Grahastha. Maturity comes. Then after the experience, I go to Vanaprastha, giving up. Then after that, I have to take sannyas. So individually, I have to go from one level to another level. This is vertical and this is horizontal. Scientific classification of human life is made in Sanatana Dharma, the glorious Dharma of Hinduism. We have to explain this to our children. Because we are not explaining this horizontal and vertical, people are manipulating and they are bringing their own theory and spoiling our children's mind. Okay? So why this problem of the jati? There is no jati in Hindu scriptures. So we have more than 100, 200 jatis. I have list, the government list. So many jatis. You never find that kind of name in our scriptures. The scriptures are talking only scientific classification of mental vritti. There is no jati based on birth. This classification is based on mental vritti. That's all. And the foreigners came inside and they classified a jati and they were divided.
And our politicians, they pour water on that or petrol on that. They also brought out that fire, and successfully they are running the country, running the states by keeping this jati system, blaming this Hindu scriptures. And they are not allowing to quieten the jati problem. They, wherever it is, wherever they see, they try to bring the jati problem. When you bring the jati problem, the people will become a group. So, okay, you support one group, the majority group, then you get vote, then you get power position, you enjoy this. So this is the politics is going on. And the blaming the Hindu scriptures. So our people, you people should take this and explain to our Balavigar children. Next generation, they have to understand. All human beings all over the world, whether they accept this, this is called what that? Dharma chart again. Dharma graph. Varnashrama Dharma graph, X axis and Y axis. We have to explain this to our children. If they ask any question, you can answer very easily. Scientifically, you can say that I am Kshatriya. Suppose Arjuna says, I am Kshatriya. Okay, you just. And Grihastha, Arjuna is married. So what is the position of Arjuna in life? Grihastha. So in his personal life, he is Grihastha. In the social life, he is Kshatriya. This is your position in life. And do your best. You also grow at the same time, do your best society. Okay, what is your work? I am skilled worker. I am skilled worker, now I am brahmachari, I am unmarried. So this is your position in your life, that's all. So we have to understand what is my position in the life according to scriptures, by nature only, not by birth. So the inner life, we have to lead by nature. The external life, we have to lead by birth. That's all. When you understand this, there is no confusion in our life. Because in the external life, we are living with all kinds of people. So we have to go with the majority of the thought. Inner life, we are alone. So we have to work inside for our evolution. That's all. Okay, when you understand this much, you will not have any confusion. We know how to take the stand. We know how to take this glass, how to put the sunglass. We know where to remove the sunglass, where to put this power glass. Okay? So the person is sannyasa. He has taken the sannyasa. The brahmana has taken the sannyasa. So he is there and he is singing the song. He is completely away from this. This is his position in his life. Avadhuta, the bhikshu. Okay? By birth, he is brahmana. And his mental vritti was like what? That he is out of the four states. Suddenly he has come to his by birth and he has taken the sannyasa. Now he is completely away from this world. Sannyasa, you should not react. Therefore, his position is here in this human life. The chart. So everybody, but a Hindu Sanatana Dharma only brings this kind of scientific classification. Very, very convincing. There is no, you will not get any doubt, question on this. Very, very clear. The Hindu Sanatana Dharma is meant for all human beings all over the world. You can fix this chart anywhere in the world. You go to Australia, you ask someone, are you married? Yes, now you are Grihastha. Where are you working? I am in the military. Okay, you belong to this part. Anywhere you go to somewhere Africa. So what is your job? I am scientist. Okay, you belong to this category. Are you married? No. The young scientist belongs to this place. That's all. You can fix this graph wherever you go. So Sanatana Dharma only brings, therefore this is called Sanatana Dharma, eternal dharma of human being. By foreigners, we were given the name Hinduism. Actually, Sanatana Dharma. You can fix this anywhere around the world. Human Dharma. Therefore, any religion comes and goes, but Sanatana Dharma never dies. Why? Even though you do not have this chart, the people are living according to this chart only. But Sanatana Dharma brings the chart. The science we have. Supreme, right? Supreme kind of thought. So we have to be very proud that we belong to greatest tradition. Our thinking, the Indian thinking is extraordinary in all the fields. All the fields. Not only in philosophy, the medicine field also, astrology, astronomy. Whatever the field you take, Indian thoughts are extraordinary. All the thoughts are because of their deep reflection, their meditation they brought. Interestingly. So therefore, you have to go by your nature. You have to go by your nature. So your question, okay? You don't go by your nature only. So this is a question. So how do I know what is my dharma? You have to understand which the work you like the most, that is your dharma. You do so many work. One work gives you satisfaction, and that work comes very natural to you. The work which is coming very naturally, after having done this, your mind is getting satisfied. You have to identify, this is my swadharma. You keep on doing so many work, and you have to analyze, hey, this is my swadharma. For Arjuna, the archery is nature, is swadharma. Therefore, he says, don't change it. You do your swadharma. Swadharma nidhanam shreya. Even if you die in swadharma, that brings you evolution. Paradharma bayavaha. Paradharma will bring unnecessary karma vasana. You will get into problem. Your revolution will be stopped. That's all. You can say, why don't I work this? Why don't I think? Sir, you are a skilled worker. You don't... Why you are a very nice carpenter. But you are thinking that scientist is higher than the carpenter. He thinks that scientist is higher than carpenter. Sir, you yourself putting it down. So you look upon that person, he is higher than my other position. Therefore, the people are doing agriculture in the field. They are giving up, they are becoming scientist. I want to become scientist. I want to wear this coat and sitting in the coat. That, it looks very nice. I want to become like that. Sir, looking it nice and you want to become that, that's okay. What is your ambition? Sir, you don't have your ambition. You go according to your nature. Then according to your nature, you work on that, you become great person in that area, sir. So what our children are thinking, if I become like this, I'll become great. Then we are losing it. So many confusions of family, society. It's very difficult to bring this concept also. So you become great person in the agriculture. They are telling agriculture, the uniform of this farmer is very not nice. And you have to get into what you call the land, what you call the paddy field. They are not liking this kind of personality. Sir, who asked you to wear this kind of dress? You wear jeans and t-shirt. You go by bike. You have your own car. You bring all kinds of technology in that field. So many technologies have grown all over the world. Bring the technology in that field. You be there, you bring prosperity, technology, all the things there itself. Are you getting it? We are thinking this work is lower and this work is higher. So I want to become all the way. You go and sit in the AC room, have very nice dress and sit on this revolving chair and you do like this. Sir, and you are not satisfied with what you are doing. And only status is coming, money is coming, satisfaction never comes in. You're letting both. The work is bore. I do not know. I have everything, but I'm not satisfied because you are not doing your swadharma. Not finding out your swadharma, work is boring and no creativity is coming. No, what that? The development is coming. So every now and then people should come and give you the refreshment goods. Boy, I'm going dull in my own work. Sir, if you find out your swadharma, there is no need of any refreshing course. Every day is a refreshment for me. Creativity comes. Curiosity comes. I develop so much. Why Arjuna become very great in his field? Because his nature. So Krishna says, this is a secret of life. Find out your nature. You go into that. Don't listen to your parents' words or your friends. Go into that. In a short time, you achieve so many things. So our problem is, we are not, thinking our work is greater work. What are you doing? Balayga teacher. Sir, don't do Balayga teacher. Very powerful work. What are you doing? I am an officer only. Simply document only I am making. So document making is not, so you can make brilliant thing in that area. Even a small work, you can make great creativity in that. So this is our mental problem. This is not the structure of the system there. The people who are working in that. And our school, the people used to come from the mechanic shop. The mechanic is giving education, nice education to their children. Auto man. One time the auto man, auto, the person, he came and said, because I am auto person, auto driver, you are treating my child like this. Say, Anyway, if it is mistake, then we will tell the teacher not to do like this. But why you are telling I am auto man? Auto driver. Then you yourself is putting it down. Why you tell us, sir, I am auto driver. See, first you have to worship and you have to think your job is higher job. This is the job is given by the Almighty Lord. I am doing it, that's all, in my best way. So that kind of attitude is the worshipful attitude. The problem comes in the human mind, not in the system. But we are blaming the system. So that is wrong. Anyway, we have to find out our place in the chart and we have to do our work in a spiritual way, we will grow. So that is the thing, okay?
Hariyam Swamiji.
I think I answered your question. Okay.
Hariyam Swamiji, we have one more question today. Nandini, please, she is waiting. If Dineshji, can we unmute her? She would like to ask the question. If you have time, Swamiji.
I will. We can see that.
And Nandiniji, can you go ahead and unmute yourself, please?
Hariyam Swamiji, what pronouns to you? Swamiji, I am a grahastha, but I prefer the, like, I don't like to get into a conflict, or I would like to do my things peacefully, and sometimes I will not fight for it because I'm not comfortable about it. And if it is something what I can do, I do my level and then I leave it, because I think in the end, no leaf even moves without his will. So why am I fighting this? This is my bigger thought in my head rather than the reason why I'm standing for. So when you are mentioning about grahasthas, we should be more action oriented and we should take up the cause and do it. I was finding it very difficult to follow it. I find it very difficult to follow that thing in my life. And I'm not having any regrets about it because I'm happy about it also. It doesn't take me too long to bounce from the negative situation I am in, because I always feel it is his wish. So am I thinking wrong, Swamiji?
Yeah, you are right only. So you yourself brought the question, you yourself answered the question.
No, but Swamiji, you mentioned that as a grahastha, we should be more
sadhu.
I am not using the word sadhu for myself because it seems too wrong. But it's not comfortable to fight. It is like I just don't feel it correct.
That is not fighting. See, when Arjuna was there in the battlefield, that is not considered as a fight. That is his duty. You getting it? So it's not fight. It's a duty. Kuru karmaiva tasmatvam. This is a karma. This is not fight. Fight means what? Based on your raga dvesha, if you bring, that is called fight. So without raga dvesha, you have to do your duty. Now see, our problem is we are admiring this. We are admiring this as a value. Whenever we see Buddha, I also should become like Buddha. Peace means, so he is sitting peacefully. Sir, inside he is working very tough time with mind. Buddha is very busy inside, but looks very calm outside. When he was doing tapas, okay? So we are completely influenced, or we are admiring all the sannyasa quality. We want to bring that quality here in grihastha. So that is the problem. So what Krishna says, you understand the sannyasa, all the physical sannyasa, all the mental sannyasa you can do completely there. But while you are living there in the society, you have your people, your sons, daughters, relatives, you have so many commitments. Living with these people, you can handle, you can bring this kind of few qualities, not complete quality. Few qualities which is you can practice here, so that is more than enough. When you drop everything, you go outside, then if somebody is spitting on us, or somebody is scolding, we can, because we are alone. When you are in the grihastha, somebody comes and they started blaming our daughter, sons. There you should not behave like bhikshu. Nayam jano me sukha dukkhe hetuhu na devatatma griha karma kalyo. You are father of their children. You are mother of their children. Sir, you have to protect them. You have to bring that kind of, when you bring the opposite thought, protect your children, protect your son, you have to bring your argument. That is needed. That is dharma of the grihastha. You understand? But you know very well that this dharma in Grahastha, if somebody takes money, you just leave it. All our karma. From your daughter, somebody is taking money. That's it. Daughter, better sit down. Don't worry about money, okay? Money will come, money will go. So what happened to my father? Before Bhikshu Gita, he was very nice. After Bhikshu Gita, he's behaving like this. Something has happened to my father. I am not sure Bhikshu Gita is meant for Bhikshu. When I finish all my duties with the daughter, with my son, my wife, children, relatives, then time comes, I become Bhikshu. There, if somebody takes money, you behave like Bhikshu. Okay? When you are there in the family, you have all kinds of for that. You have to react, you have to see, you have to get money, you have to protect, you have to grow the money. All the things you have to do. While you are doing this thing, you have to understand all this is the duty I have to do according to my place and position. That's all. With all understanding of the Brahma Vidya, you have all connection. Even though you have connection, you don't attach. How? Padma Badram Ivambasa. The Bhagavan Krishna says, how the water is in the lotus leaf, in the same way, you also behave. Okay? So there you have to, even though you are not reacting based on your raga dvesha. So reaction is needed in that particular place to get the work done. Oh, that kind of understanding will come more when you are reflecting, you will get that kind of clarity. Then you will not get any confusion. So we should not behave like sannyasa here. Sannyasa attitude should be there, not as sannyasa. Okay? In the practical life. Yes. When somebody comes and does some problem with our children, you have to protect. So physically also you have to go and protect. What is this? So you have to protect this. And mentally you have to protect them. And you have to give them all kinds of counseling, support, security, all this to our children. You have to be there for them. And you understood. Their life is different. My life is different. We are coming together, living together based on love and duty. That's all. With that proper Vedantic understanding, you have to do it. So you are a CEO of the company. Okay? You are the CEO of the Brahmana. You are the CEO of the company. The person is coming always late to the company, creating problem. You have to show your anger. Sir, there you are not Bhikshu. CEO of a company manager, you have to say, hey, whoa. Again and again telling so many times you are doing the same thing, you will be get out of this company in 1 week if you are not rectifying this problem. This man will not say, you studied Bhikshu Gita last week, why you are behaving like this, sir? The other person is asking, hey, if I become Bhikshu, then I will react. I am CEO of the company, manager of the company. Get this work done. I will be tough only. The work nature, we have to take a role, we have to take and we have to act. See that very interesting, our Janaka Maharaj, he was fighting with so many enemies. He had army. As a king, he was doing his role. When he finishes everything, if he becomes Bhikshu, then he has to go to forest, he will react like Bhikshu. Are you getting it? So what kind of dress you are wearing, according to that you have to act. When you remove the dress, then you are a different person. That's all. The role, the position is very important. So according to that, we have to do. So studying the scripture is a different thing. Where is my role, my position? According to that, how I have to convert that into this and I have to work on the wall. Okay,
va? Thank you so much.
Oh, Sanatana Dharma is very great. When you understand this from different angle, it's very beautiful. It's like big statue. It's a very big statue. Suppose you go to Gujarat, you see this, our Patel statue. From the distance, different. From the backside, from the top, from the side. You just go near the that statue, you see from his feet, totally different. So Sanatana Dharma is very, very big, very big. Different position, different angles. Why? We are very much blessed to take birth in this dharma. Being Hindu is not ordinary. So you must have done aneka janma sama, But Satakodi Janma Sukurtaihi Punyehi Vina Na Labhyate. Without that kind of punya, you will not take birth in this. See this, the structure of the everybody is included. Whether you are a Hindu or non-Hindu, you are included in this chart. This is the glory.
Can you hear me?
Are you?
Yeah, Swamiji, elaborating on the same question by Nandini ji and this one. Suppose you are working in a company or like you are doing some business. So should we like, see, there's always a competition or work to brag or like, I mean, not even to brag, actually, you did something. Like in the company culture, you have to talk about it. Like, hey, I did this one. Hey, I am the one who did that. But personally, spiritually, we don't want to talk about it, right? We want to be noticed for the work we did rather than by keep on talking about it. And growth in the company also sometimes managers say, hey, if you don't talk about what you did, who will recognize you?
Okay.
So good. How we should behave in a company world, Swamiji?
Yeah, your manager's right. Your manager's right. And you have to now. So what I see here in when I visit your place there, the children used to give their summary in the university. I heard in a few places. The children used to give the summary, whatever they have done in their life. Summary means their own history. So in India, if you come and ask, they will not give this. So if I write about myself, I feel shy. Yes. So I will not tell about myself, my own, what that, the activity, whatever I told. Because we were trained in such a way that you should not tell about yourself. So what I feel, that is not the right way of doing it. If time comes, you have to tell about your thing. There's no wrong in it. You take Valmiki Ramayana. Valmiki Ramayana is written by Valmiki. In that, Valmiki himself says about himself. You take Mahabharata. In Mahabharata, Vyasa also comes. But Vyasa is author of the Mahabharata. Whenever Vyasa comes, he said, Vyasa appeared here. Vyasa gave suggestion to Pandavas. Vyasa is writing that. You getting it? So there is no that. So you can tell your own history or about your work. In two ways, without attaching, the time is needed, the place is needed, I am telling my work. There is no wrong in it. Many people, they will tell their own history to glorify themselves, to show their ego, that is wrong. You're getting it? If a manager says that, if you are not telling your work, nobody will recognize. The company is needed that kind of work. It is not based on your ego or your showing, show off. It is based on the time and the place it is needed. Then there is no wrong in it. You have to tell. Okay? When Krishna says about himself, so I am the great, I am the glory, glorious Lord, I only create everything. That is not the ego. Because of ego, he says. The fact he is telling. He has to tell. Otherwise, who will tell about Krishna? So Paramatma himself has taken on form of Krishna and he says about his own glory. But that glory is needed for the human being to get evolution. So that is needed. There is no wrong in it. So on what basis you are telling? And based on your show off or ego, then that is not appreciated. This is the place and the time is needed, this kind of introduction, then we have to tell ourselves. There is no wrong in it. I hope you understood, Jairam.
Yeah, thank you, Swamiji. Yes, got it.
The practical difference of what I am telling you, when you study the scriptures, I have noticed so many people in our life. You are very good. You are already a sadhak, that's all. So what you are living in your life is, you are right. You just move on. So then why we are studying the scriptures? We are studying the scriptures, whether our life is right or wrong. To get the confirmation, that's all. This is what I have noticed. Many people I have noticed, you are all in right path only. What your manager is telling is very perfect. What your question is, that is very perfect. So you want to confirm. To confirm our life only, we are studying the scriptures. That's all. So 99% of our people are very good, dharmic people. How you have to live, you are living there. By nature, you are living a dharmic life. Then why I should study the scriptures? Then you have to confirm whether I am right or not. Therefore, you are studying it. Okay?
And
so in the company and all, you need to tell, this is my company, this is me, this is what I have done. Not showing off. You know very well that this is not show off or ego or likes and dislikes. This place is needed. There is no wrong in it. Bhagavan Vedavyasa has done in his own work. Bhagavan Valmiki has done in his own work. Krishna also is expressing his own idea. So attitude is important. Okay? Very practical thing. Sanatana Dharma is highly practical.
Mijay, this is Neelam. Neelam, you had said about the Yama and the Niyama. So in the Niyama, like how it's a personal thing, you know, you had said personal values kind of. So the Ishwar Paridhana, how we surrender to the Lord. I know you had said pray to the Lord, but like it was written there and, you know, we surrender to the Lord. So in our personal, you know, in the purification of our mind, to handle our, you know, the emotions as per se, right? What we are going through in life with our family or whatever at work, or can we just surrender? That is also a part of the thing, right?
surrender the word is a little confusing. Surrender means to give up everything. The word is not, the translation is not good. How we understand the non-harming, the same way surrender. So sometimes this translation brings a lot of confusion. Isha surrender is not, saranagati means what, that something you give up everything and he will take care. That is not like that. Surrender means, so I am created by the Almighty Lord. So I have my position, my relatives, friends, my duty, my lifetime, how much I have to live, when I have to die, all the things are decided by the Almighty. First, you have to understand this. Okay. Surrender means the attitude setting in our mind. Whatever happens in my life, good or bad, everything is provided by God or karma. I do not know. But I know the Almighty Lord. So whether you give or karma gives, I'm not worrying about. Whatever comes, I will take it up. And you have provided me this life, whether it is good or bad, whether I am a woman or man, whether short life or long life, I am ready to accept whatever comes in my life as your prasad. This is called saranagati. That's all.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever the skills I have, that is okay. So I have little skill, then I developed more skill. Thank you very much. So you have to consider him as your friend. That's all.
Right.
He's our friend. Very nice person. Lord is very nice person. He creates nice fruit, nice flowers, a nice setup of creation.
Yeah.
That's all. So you the consider blessings. Him as your friend. Mind setting is called surrender. That's all. So what we understand, you surrender everything to him, he will take care. How he will take care? He's taking your whole, and he is giving us freedom. He's given the 5 sense organs. Mind, everything is okay. Thank you very much. I lead my life. That's all. The mindset is called surrender. And he will take care. He will take the, why he has given you the buddhi? Buddhi he has given. We have to use the buddhi. Okay? And he has given full freedom. So many things he has given. Oh God, you take care of your life. I will take care of my life. But you be friendly with me. That's all. That's more than enough. So I do whatever I can do for your temple. I can do whatever I can do for society I belong to. Very limited life. Very short span. Very limited jiva. Just you live your complete life wherever you are. All right. Surrender means you should not ask. He has to take everything. Pandava surrendered. How much problems they have undergone. So we are thinking, if I become a devotee of Lord, I should not get any problems. Sir, you also will get... Actually, the devotees are getting more problem than ordinary people.
Yes.
So we think that if I become a devotee, I should not get any problem. So that kind of attitude is wrong attitude. You have to put that side. Whether I get a wrong experience, a good experience or bad experience, you give me the strength to handle. That's all. Thank you very much. I will come and meet you on the temple. That's all. The temple. You have to keep this kind of attitude. This is called surrender. But so many things we misunderstand. The scripture is correct, but our understanding about this thing is not. So we should not tell our ahimsa, ahimsa, you should not harm anyone. Sir, doctor is harming. Doctors, what that? Putting injection is the harmful one. Harmful means what? Painful. But his attitude is the ahimsa, doctor's attitude. Then he has to do operation. He has to pinch all over the body with a needle. So ahimsa means what? Not the physical hurt is here, himsa. The attitude setting in the mind is ahimsa. You are very harsh, your daughter, you are very harsh, your son. Why? That is ahimsa. So we are taking literally ahimsa. We should not speak harsh. We should harsh words. We should not use this kind of, that is not ahimsa. Attitude behind the action should not harm the society, should not harm the soul. That is called ahimsa. That's all. So you are giving instruction to the children that don't harm anyone. That is general law. Then because when snake comes, when dog is what they're chasing us, what to do? Not harming the dog. Dog, you come and bite me here. What is this? So not harming means what? This is a mental attitude. Gurudev says, ahimsa is not possible physical level. When you are lying down, you just turn this side. 5 mosquitoes we killed. Some insect came, we turned. 80 kilogram of weight. So many insects are dying in the body. Physical level, ahimsa is not possible. The ahimsa is a mental value. So in mental level, we should not harm anyone. This fellow needs so much. He has to get. This is called himsa. You should not follow this himsa mental. So this is mental discipline. Physically, it is not possible. So our understanding is wrong. Therefore, we bring problem. Scriptures are okay. So we try our best to how to understand this. Okay, va? So I move today. Tomorrow we'll meet. So tomorrow we'll have question. Okay. Okay, shall I move?
Hari
Om. Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.